Shout out Corner Time. I'd like to say thank you to Katsura, Martin Flores, and Lawrence Russell for the joint membership. Jewel Shine, Chan Badsash, Games Layer Channel, Orochi Chris, Blitzstock Sang, Your Friendly Coco, Mr. Morningstar, Veldora 666, Sean Mark Kofas, Yasser Maki, RR Timo, David Livingstone Han, Yu Yang Ho, Combo Man 70, Mad Dude Grand Cross, Ayus Raj Ghost, Barun Bakil, Russell Place, Popsi Maneja, All The Way, Abshek Malik, Jay Patel, Sokahin, Tausher Chowdhury, Saber Rider, Thomas Mone, Mr. Rexpit, Inti Lagos Brown, I Am King, Sapto the Explorer, Ashek Skylark, Ashborn, Angela 001, Lulu KH, Unknown Helper, Chrono Legionnaire, and OGB, Lucas Makinyon, Osman Goni, and Abdel Hakim Ben Slim. Like, subscribe, and comment to be featured on the next Shoutout Corner happening on the next video. Subscribe to 2300 Gaming, guys, and let's start the video now. Hi guys, welcome back. This is 2300 Gaming again. We have another King of Fighters news and update. Okay, so they're really used to releasing 2 and 2s now instead of 1s and 1s with the King of Fighters 15. And finally, when Leona came down last week, came into the trailer, we are almost sure that the Ikari team is already in the game. Because like the two characters shown on the silhouette that was shown previously is confirmed, it's Ralph and Clark. Okay, so in this video I'm gonna be showing you what are their skill sets on what's gonna be happening. That's like the counter is a little bit accentuated here in this trailer, so I'm not quite sure if like it's a really cancel basic or cancel combo or cancel, like it's a little bit weird, but like let's look at that cancel combos there. It's really important to look at that because that's gonna be part of the game itself when King of Fighters 15 is gonna be coming out very soon. Okay, so let's go to that trailer. So we first look at the stage, and this is like a homage of Metal Slug. So they already put out a new Metal Slug trailer, a new game, and this stage is really out there, really really good, because like Ralph Jones, Leona, and Clark was one of the playable characters in Metal Slug. So yeah, so as you can see here, we're slowing it down so that we can see what's going on with what they're doing right now. They're not that buff compared to Ryo Sakazaki. At least they have, both of them has necks. Because like in King of Fighters 13, Ralph is really really buff, like full on steroids. Look at this, look at that. So it's a counter but an offensive counter. That's what I feel like. All the while I thought that counter, you need somebody to punch you in order for that to activate. But this, as you can see there in the slow motion, you can still punch. It's like an offensive counter either or somebody punches you while you're activating that, so you can counter them, you can guard crush them, or you can use them as a combo on part of your basic combo. So they have all of the skills that you have from the previous Ralph and the previous Clarks of the world. And yeah, looking really smooth. Like, the stage is really what caught my attention here. I'm not really paying attention to what they're doing, but look at this. See, look at that. That violet thing. So this is the EX. That's the EX attack. So the red one is the super. So yeah, the flat. So yeah, this is the super as well. Boom. So this is a patented Clark super. And then he will drop him to the ground and then like fall off with an elbow. So as you can see there, that the one that really caught my attention is the violet flash. So I feel like it can be a counter. It can be a guard crush. Like, no, it's not a guard crush. Like, counter crush. Like, counter combo crush. Like, if you're doing your basic combo, somebody punches you, and then you activated that, it will cancel his combo, and then you can attack. You can retaliate from there. Okay? Plus, you can also use that as a connection to your combos as well, which you saw there earlier. It's really cool. Like, there's gonna be lots of... they said that, like, King of Fighters is really difficult for new players because of the command list on the combo strings, especially in King of Fighters 13. Lots of really... Look at that. See? You can use that as a punch. But, like, if somebody punches you while you're doing that, they can counter you from there. See? Look at that. Look at that. See? He can counter you. That's really a good, like, it's an offensive defensive type of skill, that violet flashing thing. Plus I like violet, so that's one of my favorite colors. So as you can see, that's the one that caught my attention here. I think that's the difference maker in this game, King of Fighters 15, compared to any other games, because like I think that's a new kind of mechanic that they added to add more spice in King of Fighters 15 and add more moveset that's more difficult to master than regular, that other fighting games. That's what I feel. Look at that. Ooh, they're just punching each other. Oh, look at this. He's doing it again. And then he cancels that, connecting it with his basic combo. This is crazy. Like, what he's doing is maximizing the power of the violet counter thingy. Okay, because initially the first two previous iteration of trailers from Ryo and Robert from Leona, we thought that it's just like a counter, and then if you cannot like do it nicely, you can get whiff punish from that. But this one, he can connect it with his combos, and it's really cool to see. So that's Clark. Hey, I'm Muscle Clark, and that's Ralph Waya, and that's King of Fighters 15 for you guys. And then the next video would be the elephant in the room. We're gonna go proceed to King of Fighters All-Star, which is like breaking news. So let's go to that. I'm really hype, okay? Really angry hype. Hi guys, welcome back again to the game that we all love and hate, but more of love, but right now more of anger. Because like just now, like an hour ago, they posted an announcement which is like really heart-wrenching and heartbreaking to my soul. Okay, as you see, my rubies is like 776. It was 7,000. If you're following this channel, I pulled live on stream my remaining 7,000 rubies, which I got nothing. I get lots of shites. Okay, shout out to Katsura for enticing me. I should have not get baited there. Next time, I'm just gonna follow my gut and not pull for rubies. Like, not pull for units that, like, I feel like it's really, really bad pulls already. So, that's adding more salt to the injury. I can't really... I'm still stressed out, like, when I remember that 7,000 pull. Wasted 7,000 rubies for that, like, nothing. So, anyways, let's get more frustrated with this announcement. Again, guys, they're gonna be giving away rubies until the 27th of May, and you can use that on the third up until 3rd of June. Okay, so the forum states there's new forums. Look at this. Come on, load it. Special signature fighter advance notice. Okay, so they're putting it like this is not technically advance notice. This is 1 week. Like yeah, you can consider it like 1 week advance. Yeah. Okay. Noted, Netmarble. So CM Yuri, I'm here to give you the advance notice about May update that will have much anticipated SS fighter Kyo Kusanagi and Iori Yagami. So we've been already speculating that they're gonna be coming into the game, but we don't know exactly what date are they coming down. People are really, really clamoring that they were hoping that this SS banner would come on a later date because we got just the 7DS, right? Compared to the 7 Nights. So how many weeks did we prepare until the BS came in? So there's like a little bit of preparation there. But right now, there's like spend after spend. Because we got the 7DS. And then after that, we get the new Volume 2 banners with the Volume 1 banner. And then right now, we haven't even replenished our resources yet. We haven't like look at my rubies, like 700. So we haven't even replenished our rubies and our resources yet, and they're gonna be saying that they're gonna be releasing another SS fighter. OMG, like Netmarble, come on. I was hoping they should have like released one of the PvE content first before releasing an SS, so that it's a celebration of that. I think that's a best move on their part. They should have released one PvE event, like PvE content, and then when it's really hard, then they will release the SS, Kyo, and Iori, which in turn can defeat that PvE content. Not just release them now, wherein like we've already completed all of the content, like Guild Raid, Chrysalid is there, like Mai, BS Rugal, Orochi, like the 7DS, they could easily complete all of the quests right now as we speak. Okay, sorry about my voice, I'm a little bit hype, you know. Plus, it's morning, I can talk whatever I want. Nobody's gonna get angry. That's just my opinion. They should have released even one PvE content. And then from there on out, people will be scratching their heads like, this is really difficult, we need something. And then boom, we're gonna release the SS characters. They should have done that instead of the SS first. And then PvE units, PvE content on the next. Which is not really a good look. Come on, Netmarble. Like, that's just me, okay? Like, coming soon through the upcoming 27th update. So, when the SS banner will come, you still have that 5,000 rubies saved. You might pull them, okay? I will be surely pulling my 5,000 rubies for them, for sure. Okay? Also, we're preparing an event where you can obtain special... This is a good news, okay? Because they're promising that... Because, like, the BS and the SS characters have... we're really having difficulty getting those memories because it's only time-exclusive, okay? Until that event ends, we cannot get them anymore. This is a good sign, okay? This is a good sign that... Just think about it, guys. It's... Our rubies are dead, technically, right now. But if they will be pulling this, like, memories... Shoutouts to Rexpleet because I was really angry earlier. I was thinking, like, what will we do with one memory? And then he's telling, bruh, it's not memory. There's an S on that. It's plural. Okay, so it's good news technically because as you know, the collab characters, the 7DS, the technique from that one is like just pull one of each. And from those one of each, you can make envelopes, like dimensional envelopes. And from that dimensional envelopes, you can awaken them to whatever star you want. Okay, even though the event already ended. Okay. So that's the problem that we had with the BS and the SS. We cannot awaken them once the event, the BS and the SS event ends. Right now, they're making one. We are preparing for an event where you can obtain special signature fighter memories as well as the fighter themselves. So we hope to look forward for it. So I'm a little bit happy with this. Like, I'm really sad because, like, I only have 5,000 rubies because the thing is, like, the rates are really bad. Like, people are getting, like, 20,000 pulls. 20,000 rubies without anything, without any BS or SS. That's last banner. But like, how can a 5,000 ruby stash get you Kyo and Iori? Like, hopefully RNG will be nicer to me this time around with that 5,000. Hopefully I can get one of each. I'm not wishing for like another unit, like an awakened one star. Because the thing is, like, if this signature summon memory will be coming in, that's gonna be a good look for Netmarble. Okay, so I'm toning it down now because I'm while reading this, this is my first time reading this, by the way. While reading this one, and while Rexplit was telling it's plural, it's not singular, it means that even with low amount of rubies, if you can pull just one of them, because in the future, they'll be releasing memories to awaken them, which is really good. Okay? So, anger changed to joy. Netmarble is really playing with my emotions right now. I'm just getting, like, I feel like I'm back to high school, like, or high school or college, looking out for, you know, looking out for love. So anyways, that's just me. Thank you, Netmarble, again, like, even though we're out of rubies, but the thing is, like, it's RNG, okay? You have 5,000 rubies there, you're not quite sure whether or not you will get them with that pool, okay? Like, they should have just, like, let us save first. That's just me. Okay? The best thing that they did was put in a PvE content that we cannot clear, then put in the SS, then from then, put in the special signature memories on how we can obtain them. So, I think that's the best. Instead of, like, SS first, then the memories, then PvE content. Okay? So that's just my feelings out there. Like, guys, like, post in your, like, comment section. How do you feel about this? I know, like, I'm a little bit angry at first, but, like, reading through the lines, if you read in between the lines, that's the problem with me. Like, I put my emotions on my shoulders. Like, sometimes I'm really, really an emotion, like, full of emotion kind of guy. So reading in between the lines, thank you, Rexpleet, for putting me down to the ground. Realizing my mistakes, like, this is a good news for everybody, like, for an unawakened Orochi, for your unawakened units, the BS that we didn't really awaken, we have now a chance to awaken them, but we don't know how to. It might be hard to awaken them, but still, because, like, at least we can awaken them, okay, guys? So even though it's hard, don't complain, because that's why they're called BS and SS, okay? It's gonna be hard to get that memory, but, like, that's what I like about this. If they're putting it like this, it's hard, it's really nice, like a nice achievement wherein you can awaken your unit using hard work and diligence. So what do you think, is this a good move on Netmarble? Was this too early, or what do you think about my opinions that they should have released PvE content first, the SS, and then how to get their memories? So that's gonna be the succession that I was thinking, compared to, like, this one, then the memories, then PvE content. So leave your comment, like, and subscribe. Again, this is 2300 Gaming, and by the way, I'm giving away 15 euro gift card. Comment on that video, one comment each. I'm not replying on that because I'm gonna be doing a raffle next week. Okay, guys, so again, just to give you an update, I'm a little bit sober now, sober with my emotions. I'm a little bit toned down. Thank you for all who came in and will be watching this video. So I hope you guys like this video. Like and subscribe again. This is 2300 Gaming, and I'm out. Peace out.